You will never eat margarine again after you learn how it's made. Margarine is whitened in order to lose its dirty gray color, and it's whitened with the help of different types of chemicals and dust from certain types of clay. Years before, the experts convinced us that margarine is completely healthy substitute to butter, but the truth, slowly, is coming out. If you are one of the people who use margarine every day in their diet, we warn you that you might get sick after seeing how it's made. The method is similar with the one of making plastic. The margarine's basic ingredients are sheep oils with suspicious quality made from seeds of soybean, cotton, turnip and fall wheat. It's probably good to mention that soy is really dangerous herb, because right now 98% of soy plantages are GMO. On the other hand, cotton is an industrial herb which is treated with toxic pesticides and insecticides, much more than the other industrial herbs. And, if you count the fact that corn is considered as a low-quality food because of the GMO production, especially the one that originates from Argentina, then the margarine ingredients really become unwanted for our daily diet. This is why they are really bad for our health. The oil made from the seeds of these plants is actually made with the hot trickling process. Through this process, a lot of free radicals are being accumulated and they are the main reason for destroying cells in the human organism. The free radicals are the main reason for premature aging, and besides that, they could also cause cancer. This product also contains oils, which are dangerous for our health. For example, the oil made from cotton seeds is one of the main ingredients of margarine, and it shouldn't be allowed for human use, because in unrefined condition it can be used as a pesticide cause of the gossypol toxin, which is used to protect the cotton. The cotton seeds also contain high amounts of high unsaturated fats. We can also mention the turnip oil, which is very popular in the last few years. It was presented by the big fast food companies. The genetically modified version of that oil allowed them to do that. The turnip oil is very delicious, but its aroma and smell are artificial. When all the oils are mixed, they add some fine nickel powder which uses as a catalyst in the process of hydrogenation and combination of trans fatty acids. Some companies use different kinds of catalysts, but they are equally toxic as the nickel powder. With the hydrogenation process, the oils are being processed by adding hydrogen on very high temperature. The metal catalyst is also involved in the process. All of that is being converted into a solid fat, which can remain solid on a room temperature. After the partial hydrogenation, the raw margarine mass is a stinky, sticky and gray mixture, which probably you wouldn't even like to look at. In order to remove the hard lumps, in the margarine mixture are added emulsifiers that look like soap, and then all the mixture is mixed again. After adding the emulsifiers and removing the hard lumps, the raw margarine mass is cleaned under high pressure and high temperature, so the bad smell will be removed. This process is called deodorization, because different additives are being added into the margarine mixture in order to smell good for eating. After that, the margarine is whitened in order to lose its dirty gray color, and it's whitened with the help of different types of chemicals and dust from certain types of clay. The next step is adding artificial yellow color and natural colors, as the ones on butter. When the margarine stops smelling bad, his taste remains unbearable. Then they add aromas, flavorings and different preservatives.